we talk shit. All right. He been talking shit to me all his life. I've been talking shit to him all life. So we might come off like we might talk a little shit, but we don't talk shit to nobody. Like, we don't really play with people. You get what I'm saying? Like, I could play with him like that, but y'all can't. It's just one of those natural things. But the flip side to all of that is that the shit that we talking, we gonna bag it up.
So what's misunderstood about the Charlotte?
That they won't be patient enough for us to bag the shit up. Just be patient. We're gonna bag it up. Trust me. Trust me, it's gonna happen.
Do you think you guys are getting to the point where we'll be the most avoided fighters in boxing?
I don't know. I don't think we the most avoided, but
no,
I know.
But you will be.
I know for sure that we not, like, they not just stepping on our toes, like, you know, we not avoided for sure. Like, you don't want to avoid all this money. You're going to get in there with one of the Charlottes, then, like you know you're going to make some good money at least. So.
Well, is there anything you took away from Evander Holyfield's gym that still sticks with you today, to this very day?
His work ethics. Evander taught me how to work. Evander taught me at a young age how to work and just stick with it. Like, you know, Evander mentored me and my twin brother from like ages like 6 to through baseball, football, and boxing. He was there for us, you know. Some one thing that a lot of people don't know about us, we grew up under Evander Holyfield. Vernon Forrest trained with Ronnie Shields. And when Evander had to go do something, we was with Vernon. So it was like those, you know, that's how long I've been knowing Al Haymon.
And he's still in touch with you. You guys still talk, you and Evander?
Yeah. I just recently spoke to Evander. Just recently talked to him, for real. Like, so crazy you asked me that. But, about 2 weeks ago, he saw my fight. I asked him, why did he have a show on the same day I was fighting? Did he not care about me? And stuff like that. We laughed. And it was just
a little theater.
Yeah, I think he had a show on the day I fought. So it was one of those.
Would you say he's the nicest guy in boxing?
One of the nicest guys. I met some real nice people in boxing.
I don't want to put you on the spot, but if you have been there present when your brother and Earl Spencer are sparring, can you tell us a bit about the sparring session without giving away any key moments?
They mean. It's real. You got to be smart. One mistake, pop. It's some stupid shit can happen. So they both on their A game. It's a paid for sparring match. You can pay to watch that. It's some good stuff. Yeah.
Do people realize that Jermell has not only you, he has Errol Spence and Derrick James at his, you know, that can sharpen his tools? Do they realize how good that is going into the ring?
They don't. Obviously, they don't realize it because Jermell is sharp, smart. He's smarter than me in the ring. I don't care as much. I want to punch your ass. He want to think about punching you. So it's a little difference in styles, and he's real clever. Like, I take a lot from him, so, you know, to get myself better.